Hello students, welcome to this session. Today I am going to present you regarding the topic of lacrimal apparatus. See, once the term apparatus comes, it includes some of the constituents. So it has got five important components, okay, or constituents forming the lacrimal apparatus. So which are those five components? So firstly, you have lacrimal gland with its ducts, excretory ducts, then the conjunctival sac, lacrimal puncta, lacrimal canaliculi, lacrimal sac, and lastly nasolacrimal duct. So in briefly, I am going to explain regarding all these components. First, moving on to the lacrimal gland, and just to show a picture about the lacrimal apparatus, so you find this lacrimal gland supralaterally in the bony part of the orbit. So you see a lacrimal gland here, and you can also appreciate the excretory ducts, which is opening to the conjunctival sac on the eye, and the small openings, the medial portions of the eye, so that is called as lacrimal puncta in the lacrimal papillae, and then draining of the fluid secreted from the lacrimal gland. You have lacrimal canaliculi, you have superior and inferior lacrimal canaliculi that is opening to a blind the sac, that is called as lacrimal sac, that is present in the lacrimal groove, and this lacrimal sac is leading towards the duct, that is nasolacrimal duct, which is opening into the inferior meatus of the nose. So once more to explain, lacrimal gland, it is located on the lateral side, the fossa of the orbit. So it has got two parts there. Orbital part is the larger part and palpebral part is a smaller part. So it is roughly J-shaped, and the J is separated partly by one muscle, that is levator palpebrae superioris. And after arising from the orbital part, the ducts, excretory ducts of the glands will cross the palpebral part also, and it is leading to the conjunctival sac of the eye, and then to lacrimal puncta, leading to superior and inferior canaliculus opening to the lacrimal sac, and then drain to the nasolacrimal duct, which is opening to the inferior meatus of the nose. So this nasolacrimal duct is guarded by a valve, which you can appreciate there in the picture, that is called as valve of Hissner. So coming to each of the components, see the location of lacrimal gland, okay. So fossa for lacrimal gland is located on the superolateral part of the orbit. So as it already told, it has got a larger orbital part and a smaller palpebral part, and in between that you can see a portion of levator palpebrae superioris muscle. Ducts of the lacrimal gland are approximately 12 in number. Okay, so as I've already told, it is like crossing the palpebral part and then opening to the conjunctival sac. So the removal of this palpebral part is equivalent to the removal of the entire gland itself, because the ducts, you are seeing it in the palpebral part also. Coming to the next component, that is conjunctiva. To explain about conjunctiva, there are two types there, the palpebral conjunctiva and bulbar conjunctiva. So to tell about palpebral conjunctiva, the inner aspect or inner layers of the eyelid, may it be upper eyelid or lower eyelid, so inner areas you find an opaque conjunctiva, so that is called as palpebral conjunctiva, okay. Whereas coming to the bulbar conjunctiva, it covers the eyeball like that and it is transparent. So supporting this palpebral conjunctiva and bulbar conjunctiva, you have the conjunctival sac in between, okay. And the upper extension or the continuation of this palpebral conjunctiva to bulbar conjunctiva, you have the two fornices, that is superior conjunctival fornices and inferior conjunctival fornices. So inferior conjunctival fornices is in location inner to the lower eyelid, superior conjunctival fornix is deeper to the upper eyelid, like that. So conjunctival sac in between the palpebral and bulbar conjunctiva, then the extension superiorly is superior conjunctival fornix, and extension inferiorly is inferior conjunctival fornix. Next, after which the conjunctival sac is leading to the lacrimal puncta with small opening there, and then the lacrimal canaliculi. So you have two canaliculi there, you can also call it as canals. So superior canals and inferior canal for the upper and lower eyelid, and this canaliculus is opening to the lacrimal sac, okay. And it is also guarded by a dilatation like that is called as lacrimal ampulla before it is draining or opening to the lacrimal sac. Next component is about the lacrimal sac. So lacrimal sac is also located in the fossa, a groove in the lacrimal bone, and also a portion of frontal process of maxilla. Also in over there you can find this lacrimal sac. Okay, so this lacrimal sac is then leading to the nasolacrimal duct. So cyst formations in the lacrimal sac, inflammations of the lacrimal sac is called as dacrocystitis. Coming to the last component, nasolacrimal duct. So this duct is leading from the lacrimal sac downwards, backwards and laterally. Okay, downwards, backwards and laterally, and it is formed by the maxilla bone, front process of the maxilla, portion of lacrimal bone, and also coming to the inferior nasal concha, and after which it is opening to the inferior meatus of the nose. Okay, as I've already told, it is also guarded by the valve that is called as valve of Hissner. So to repeat, all the five components are present, constituting like the lacrimal gland and its duct. Okay, then the conjunctival sac, lacrimal puncta, lacrimal canaliculus, that is superior and inferior canaliculus, and lacrimal sac, and lastly nasolacrimal duct. All this collectively is called as lacrimal apparatus. Thank you.